Actress Karen David, your accent is so fantastic. Can you read your own introduction? Can you read the prompter? Can you see it from here?
Yes.
Go ahead.
You know her from the show Gallivant and Legacies. Now she's generating a lot of buzz on Fear the Walking Dead.
Well done.
It's beautiful, Karen.
You know, that is the perfect voice for the airline safety, you know?
Yes.
You would make me feel comfortable.
You would.
Yeah.
You soothe us.
You soothe us.
Yeah.
When I was on, when I was filming Legacies, they would always tease me in the writer's room because they're like, you can give Karen anything to read. They were very kind in saying this. And she could just read the dictionary and make it sound interesting. And I said, okay, really? I said, okay, no pressure.
And then something like Gallivant is very like, ta-da.
Yes.
But you're singing in Fear of the Walking Dead?
I am. I sang just this past Sunday's episode, which was so magical because it's amazing. You know, music is so healing and can bring all of us together and unite people from all walks of life. And I just love that I had this moment with the amazing, legendary Reuben Blades. And so it was a very magical moment for us.
Wow, that's fantastic.
And I've never played guitar before.
Really?
So did they bring somebody in to tell you how?
So my husband is a songwriter producer. So I was very lucky that he happens to be like a virtuoso on the guitar. So I just went into a mad panic saying, I have to learn the Traveling Wilburys. Can you please teach me? And he's like, oh boy, how long have you got? I was like, 2 weeks. So literally every day. And thank goodness it was a section of the song, but I got calluses and all, like proper, and
wow.
I love it. Yeah.
Now, how is that? Because that resets the, now we're going to get into something really good. That resets the dynamic between you and your husband for those 2 weeks, doesn't
yeah,
it?
Right, yeah, because now
teacher
he's
student.
Like,
teacher student.
Exactly. But he's a great teacher and very, very patient. So thank you, love. He's watching, so.
All right, here, before we get to this clip, this is the headline. There was some conference yesterday, and people at AMC, the network, say they feel there is material for Fear of the Walking Dead, this is an exact quote, to last for decades.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. This is the apocalypse. Anything can happen. Expect the unexpected. That's what I keep saying, you know, to the fans, because, you know, the past couple of episodes have been very tumultuous, and we don't know. I'm worried for Grace. You know, we received the scripts very last minute, you know, because it's all the element of surprise for us too,
sure.
Which is exciting as well. But literally when we get the script, we're kind of just like glued to the page and we're like, oh my gosh, oh my gosh.
And then one oh my gosh element is, oops, I really liked him and he's not here anymore.
Yeah. Or, yes, that can happen.
Right.
Yeah. It could be a Game of Thrones a la Red Wedding at any moment. So you just never know. So.
Wow. With that in mind, we were soothed. Now we're upset.
Yeah.
Here's a clip. Take a look.
The klaxon.
The containment structure.
We gotta go. We gotta go.
Exactly.
Right, where's the Uber?
Where's the Lyft?
Go, don't look.
All right, an unfair criticism. Are you a bad driver? Is Grace a bad driver?
Under pressure, maybe.
You know, when they first brought, I've named the truck Roxy, affectionately, and when they brought Roxy out, I was like, wow, now I'm used to everyone being taller and bigger than me. And when that truck came out, I was like, I have to drive that truck? I was like, that is huge and monstrously big. And they're like, yeah, but you can handle it.
Yeah.
You can handle it.
You know, our producer of this show is named Roxy.
Oh, really?
And she, too, is not unlike a huge monstrous truck.
Whoa.
Not in a bad way.
In a powering
name. In a powerful way.
Yes.
There we go. Fear the Walking Dead airs Sunday nights at 9 on AMC. How nice to meet you this morning.
Thank you, Karen.
Thank you for having me.
You bet.